You have to understand the difference between business and life. Business is purely transactional. Okay? Something you give, something you get back. And it doesn't hurt if the loss is there, loss is there. But it doesn't hurt lifelong. But life is not transactional. Okay? Suppose in business some customer doesn't pay you money. It'll hurt you for some time, then you forget it. But in your life, if doesn't somebody didn't smile you, smile at you, a friend, then you'll get hurt for 10 years. Why? Because life you have made into transactional. Never make life as transactional.
Yeah.
Okay? Make life out of love. In love, there's no transaction. Okay? Sri Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Phalam Patram Pushpam Toyam. The God says, I don't expect anything from my devotee. If a devotee gives me one little bit of water, toya, patra, one flower, one leaf, one flower, it's fine. He may have millions of dollars. But I don't expect that. Because God doesn't need anything from you to feel happy. Right? So the moment God becomes transactional, oh, you didn't give me, you got $1 million, you didn't give me 1% commission, then there's no God.
Yeah.
Right? So, the transaction spoils life. Okay. Live a life, say that my happiness is not dependent on transaction. Simple definition. I am happy, I am peaceful, I am love. I am okay. And say other person is also okay. Even though other person doesn't understand this transaction business, still that person may expect some transaction from you. Okay? That doesn't matter. You do your best. And other person gets hurt, it's his headache, not your headache. Understand? See, what we say, many times some other person gets hurt, we start thinking, oh, I'm guilty. Remove guilt from your life. You are not guilty of hurting somebody else. If somebody else is hurting, they are hurting themselves more than what you are hurting them. Guilt is another problem of our life. Okay? The moment you remove transactions in your life, say, I don't expect anything from anybody, you will be filled with love. In love, you always do something. It will be giving, not seeking. What is the difference between seeking and giving? In seeking, you are seeking happiness from the other person. In giving, you are out of happiness, you are giving somebody. You are not a beggar. In seeking, you become a beggar. The moment you become a beggar, you are a miserable life. Never be a beggar, be a king. How I can give something to somebody? Okay? So that it becomes a relationship of love. Don't make life as transaction. Make a love life out of love. Pure love. No expectations. The moment expectation is there is attachment. Okay? Then if you start living this life, you'll do best for any relationship. Okay? But the other person doesn't understand life. Unfortunately. Because people are living in their own illusions. The other person may still expect a transaction from you. And the other person may get hurt. But now you'll never feel guilty. Because you understand why the other person is feeling hurt is not because of me. But because the person doesn't understand life. The problem is his understanding of life. Otherwise, what will happen? Now you're looping back earlier. Oh, that person got hurt. I have done something wrong. Already you're miserable like a beggar seeking something. Then over that you're adding guilt that why? So now once you understand that, yes, I am free. I am full of love. How to nourish the relationship? I know. You do that. Then somewhere some other person gets hurt. Nobody can be pleased all the time. But you'll not feel guilty. Okay? You'll help the person. You'll meet the person. You'll transact with the person. Interact with the person. Out of love. Not out of guilt. Not out of fear. The fear is also there. Oh, this person is hurt. Tomorrow he'll walk out of my life. A love doesn't get affected whether the person is in your life or out of life. Your love. But attachment gets affected. Attachment hurts. So you will be free from seeking happiness from somebody. You will be free from guilt. You will be free from hurt. If the hurt is caused, the person is walking out of your life. You will not feel hurt. You will wish a good wish for that person. At the same time, the person comes back, you will be fully as much loving. Live a life of love, not of attachment. Be free from guilt. You cannot hurt anybody. The person hurts himself. Look at your life. If somebody has told you something and you got hurt, but you hurt yourself more, again mentally repeating that. The person whipped you once, person hit you once, but you hit yourself every day remembering that person. That person is only responsible for one crime. You are responsible 10,000 crimes you are doing for yourself. Why are you whipping yourself? Why are you feeling in guilt? Free that person. Live in love. Rather not get trapped in love. Getting trapped in love is called attachment. English is a beautiful language, right? In English, they say, fell in love. Finished guy. The guy fell. He has fallen in love. He didn't rise in love. He's trapped. Okay? Why it's called fell in love? It's an expression of human language. We fell in love because you got into attachment, entanglement. And entanglement is hurting. It will not allow both of you to come out. Okay? You have to rise in love, not fall in love. And rise in love, you free that attachment. Say, I am free. You are free. Let us be loving rather than slaves of each other. Is it clear? Any questions? Becoming indiscriminate. Okay? I said love is all about giving. Love is about nourishing. So then I keep on giving, then I become a beggar. I can't survive because I keep on giving. I didn't mean that. Okay? I never meant be indiscriminate. Use your discrimination. Okay? By giving to somebody and continuously, that person will not grow. Your intention of giving is to the extent of helping him to grow rather than making him depend on you. Right? So I can keep giving so that somebody becomes dependent on me. It is not the idea. Your idea of giving should make him independent, should make him free from you. Right now, you have become free. Okay? But he is dependent on you. He is seeking something from you. He has not become attained freedom. Your objective of that giving is to help him become free from the dependency on you. To that extent, you have to give. Don't overdo it. Don't go overboard. Okay? Don't kill yourself by giving. You give to help a person to make him free from you. Become independent. Stand on his own leg. Find his inner strength. Grow. I'm giving the example of children, right? I have my children. Okay, I want to give to my children. Give. Because they are dependent on you. They are not earning something. They are dependent on you. Their entire life is dependent on you. But don't make them so dependent that at the age of 50, mama, then you have made them slaves. That's not the idea. You have to teach them, help them to grow, become independent, not only from you, from anybody, so that they are free, the same freedom what you have attained internally. Frame love what you feel yourself. He should feel. Right now, he is dependent on you. So, our relationship, I can be enlightened relationship, but all people around may not be that nature, right? And you cannot throw them out also. You cannot give them an everyday sermon. Okay? You become free. You can't. They can't accept sermon. They can accept sermon only from a master with their trust, not from you, because they think you are a relative. Right? It's like going to a doctor, no? If doctor gives a medicine, it's good. If friend gives the same medicine, you don't accept it. Like that, a wisdom has to come from a source which is higher than you. So you cannot keep making other person give sermon every day. You understand, this person is dependent on me. So now how I can help him to grow? how I can help him to become free, independent, gain inner strength. So I would say in other way, don't give fish every day to somebody. Help him learn how to do fishing. This is the principle of giving. When I say keep giving, it doesn't mean that you become indiscriminate. Right? You become free internally. You become peaceful. You become loving. Other person still attached. Help him to grow out of that attachment into a pure, loving, wise person. Whatever is required for that, to that extent you do. Did I answer your question? So, when I say love, make life as not transaction, life as giving. That doesn't mean that indiscrimination. Give to help the person to grow, to help anybody to grow. Become free, become independent. Learn, make the person full of love rather than more of attachment, to the extent possible. Don't be indiscriminate. Okay, now it doesn't mean that killing yourself for doing that. You have to survive to do that. By killing yourself, somebody else will grow. It doesn't work that way, right? You need your body, mind, health. By spoiling your body, mind, health, you cannot help anybody. Then you become a patient. You become dependent on them. You have to retain that. Now, is body, mind, and health, intellect is important? It is important. To the extent you realize yourself. When you realize yourself, body, mind, intellect becomes irrelevant. There are great beings who have done a lot of sacrifice, but they have done the sacrifice after they have realized that body, mind, intellect is no longer valid and relevant for them. Okay. The great beings like Shankaracharya, Vivekananda, they left their life after the age of 30 or 32. They have done whatever is possible. The work is over. The vehicle is over. The body, mind, intellect. They have left that. But until you come to that stage, you need the vehicle. The body and intellect. You cannot damage it. Do with that vehicle what is best for others. So that they grow. Okay. And don't feel guilty if you are not able to do the best. Discrimination, you have to apply your discrimination. What should be done, what should not be done. But discrimination is one thing. It cannot be perfect. It can be a mistake. Don't kill yourself with the mistake you have done. Oh, I did a mistake. Yeah, people do mistake in life. Accept it. The guilt kills you, not the mistake. Don't create a guilt for you by doing whatever you have done. Learn from it. Go ahead in life. Okay. Do you know how many times a child falls before it starts walking? Have you an idea? Scientists have seen on an average more than 1 lakh times child falls before it walking. Falling is not a mistake. If the child becomes guilty, if it falls first time, they will never walk in life. So fall. Use your discrimination. You make a mistake. Correct it. Go ahead. Don't kill yourself. Learn how to give, how to nourish the relationship rather than become a beggar in relationship. You have to ask your question, I am a beggar in relationship or I am a king in relationship.